Rooster's Men's Grooming Center is a proud sponsor of Ranger football. It's a classic American barbershop updated for the modern man. Rooster's Men's Grooming Center, located on 1431 across the street from the 1890 Ranch Shopping Center, next to the Tower Car Wash. It's not just a barbershop. It's a men's grooming center. The atmosphere is amazing. Brand new, clean, big screen TVs, oversized leather barber chairs, and relax. We'll bring you a cold beverage of your choice. Mike and his team of experienced stylists love and are proud of what they do, and they will take care of you. Rooster's Men's Grooming Center, located on 1431 across the street from the 1890 Ranch Shopping Center. Check them out. Rooster's Men's Grooming Center. Walk-ins are always welcome, but you can always make an appointment. Call Rooster's Men's Grooming Center, 512-528-0520. That's 512-528-0520.
Hey guys, welcome to the Coach Vincent Show here at Rooster's Men's Grooming Center off 1431. I'd like to start off our show with our players of the week and our hard hats.
Our offensive lineman of the week was Jake Shelton. Offensive back, Matt Snow. Wide receiver of the week was J.D. Hill. Offensive most valuable player was Stebbin Mayberry. Defensive back of the week was Kevin Harris. Defensive lineman was Steven Alexander. Our linebacker of the week was Brett Burrington. And our defensive most valuable player was split between Jake Hicks and Micah Thomas. For our special forces, most valuable player was Jake Hicks and Blake Gossett. Hammer award this week for the biggest hit was Kevin Harris. And our RBI goes to Tyler Zeman.
And every week we like to honor our hard hats. These guys go absolutely all the way, just as hard as they can go through practice during the week. And they give our varsity just a fantastic look. This week it went to Kyle Armstrong, Justin Hebert, Noah Garza, Carlos Ralda, Brennan Eggers, Bryce Dahl, Cole Patterson, Parker Stallings, and Garrett Clark. And Garrett Clark's been on here almost every week so far. This guy is, he's a tough one. All right, and with that, we'd like to talk a little bit about Leander. What are some overall highlights? I know we didn't come out with the win, but overall, you got to see some good things and some bad things.
Well, I felt like we improved in a lot of areas, Gage. That's what's tough about it is you look on tape, and we've got guys playing hard, and we've improved in a lot of areas. We just weren't good enough to overcome the mistakes we made. You know, I was telling someone the other day, you make a mistake for a minimum-type gain, and sometimes you can recover from it, but we made mistakes that turned into two touchdowns for Leander, and that's really tough. Defensively, saw some improvement up front and with our linebacker play, some of the best linebacker play we've had all year. Unfortunately, in the secondary, we had some trouble with some spacing on some coverages at times, and so that was the biggest difference in the game. Really proud of the way we ran the football against Leander and saw some great improvement with our offensive line and some things that they were doing up front.
I think overall, I know personally talking to some of the fans and then talking to some of the players, I think it was probably the best effort overall from the team.
Yeah, I felt like we've put together six quarters of the way we should be playing as far as just how hard we play. You know, minus the mistakes, we've put together some really good offense and defense, but how hard our team is playing says a lot about what kind of team we have and what kind of players we have.
And what are some things defensively that we're going to have to take care of against Marble Falls? I know they're pretty good offensively.
Yeah, they're coming in with a lot of yardage and they can score a lot of points. When their offense is on, they're as good as any offense in our district. I mean, they really are. They've got a quarterback that operates their system really well. They got a tailback that's a downhill runner. He's big. He's physical. And, of course, they've got a wide receiver that's committed to Texas that – who's an exceptional player, and then they've got a guy that complements him really well. So, I mean, they've got four guys that can make a lot of plays. They do a good job, Gage, of really stretching the field vertically with their vertical passing game. But they also can run the ball really well and can hurt you with the short passing game. So we've got to do a really good job of mixing up what we do against them, whether we pressure them, whether we use a full coverage type package, so that we got to mix that up, and we got to be in the right spaces against them, and try to create some turnovers. We want to get some stops, get our offense some extra possessions.
And what about offensively? What are some key things there?
Well, they're improved defensively from a year ago. That was one of the things I felt like, you know, they said they needed to improve on when, you know, visiting with their coaching staff, and they have. They've improved. We've got to really take advantage of our speed on offense, and they're a team that we feel like that if we can maintain good 4-second blocks or be whistle players like we were the other night up front and with our skill guys, I feel like we can establish a running game. Also, just looking at their secondary, I think the way they're set up and the way they play, I think there's some things we'll be able to do throwing the ball also. Our play action stuff will be good, some of our short passing game, some of our passes down the field off of our play action I think are going to be really good against them. Overall, though, I feel like they've improved. They're a better tackling team. They run to the ball better. And hopefully some of the sets and things we can put out there can create some mismatches and some things that we need to do offensively.
And then how about on special teams? I know we here at Vista Ridge, Texas, that's something we take really strongly into importance.
You know, the other night, for the first time in a long time, we had a miscommunication on special teams. But for the most part, pretty good on special teams. Feel like that our speed on special teams could give us an advantage against Marble Falls. They've got a sound special teams. You can tell they're well coached on it, but I feel like this is another area that if we really work hard and do what we're supposed to do, we have a chance to be good in this game with.
And then what about during the week, not just with our varsity, but other things going on in Vista Ridge, Texas?
Well, our JV gets the home game this week. Thursday night we'll have two games. Our first game, our JV Black will play Leander again, and then because Marble Falls doesn't have a second JV team, and then our JV Red will be playing Marble Falls right after that out at Ranger Stadium. I wanted to, you know, really give a big thank you for everyone that participated in our breast cancer awareness games. We've had, you know, five fantastic games for that, and people really contributed for good causes, towards that. Also, just wanted to highlight, you know, our players. We've got all our academic reports in now, 74 of them, AB honor roll, 12 of them on all A honor roll, another 21 or one grade away from being honored on that group. And we're really excited about what some of our guys are doing in the classroom, Gage, and Wednesday. We look forward to honoring them with our normal academic pep rally and sticker ceremony in our study hall. So I'm proud of those things that are going on in our program. Had a real good turnout at Rutledge Carnival, one of our elementaries. A lot of our guys went over and served at that. I got great feedback from all the folks at Rutledge Elementary about the way our guys helped out in that program also.
And with that, that'll end our Coach Vincent show for this week. I'm Gage. Thank you guys for watching.
Go. I'm Kelsey.
I'm Brittany.
I'm Melissa.
And you're at Roosters Men's Grooming Center.
Go Rangers!